stay to the end of this video for an exclusive interview, and shout out to Jarhead02Horse for bringing this story to my attention. So while Colin Kaepernick is over there making book covers depicting dark-skinned black women as some aggressive social justice warrior calling for the abolishment of the police and closing the prisons, we have this Karen who took it up a notch, named Hannah Payne. If you're not familiar with this case, you're in for a wild ride, literally, so buckle up. Hannah Payne, age 21, decided to pursue 62-year-old Kenneth Herring when she allegedly witnessed Herring supposedly leaving the scene of a motor vehicle accident with another vehicle. Now, we all know these Karens are all members of the Justice League. So she did what all Karens do when they see black people doing anything. She called 911. But this Karen took it up a notch. She didn't leave it there. I mean, why would she? She pursued Mr. Herring, although the 911 operator explicitly told her not to follow him. She then cut Mr. Herring off in traffic, exited her vehicle with her firearm. She then proceeded to scream at this 62-year-old diabetic elder, who at the time of this accident was on his way to the hospital because he was in the middle of a diabetic episode. This Hannah Payne, who takes her last name quite literally, aggressively told him, "Get out the car! Get out the car! Get out the effing car or I'm going to shoot you!" And when he did not comply, she did what all Karens are predisposed to doing, you know, police black people and take justice in their own hands. She shot Mr. Herring in the chest, ending his life. If you've gotten this far, please remember to like and subscribe. This Hannah Payne, after driving and gunning this man down, tells the 911 dispatcher that he shot himself with her gun. Now, according to this so-called law, it allows citizens to arrest someone if a crime is committed in their presence. But looking at her family members and where she's from, this isn't the first time she's so-called witnessed a crime. I guess this citizen arrest only applies to black people. But moving on. Now, this all took place in May of 2019. She had a bond hearing, another one, on July 16th of 2020, which was held via Zoom, where she requested, through her overzealous attorney, to modify the conditions of her previous bond hearing. You heard me right. She was out on bond. The attorney, a Matthew Tucker, laid bare on the court that Payne, who pursued, attacked, and ended this man's life, is now struggling financially to pay the cost for the ankle monitor that she is required to wear. And she is unable to work overtime due to the curfew she has to adhere to under the conditions of her bond. Mind you, this Karen is charged with a felony murder, and yet she was granted bond only weeks after she pursued, attacked, and ended this 62-year-old man's life. Really? As if this case isn't ridiculous enough, when she was granted her bond, she stated to the court that she did not mind wearing an ankle bracelet. And during the Zoom hearing, her facial expressions is described as shifting from pensive to annoyed, as the prosecutor reminded her that she said that she did not mind wearing said ankle bracelet. Her attorney also added that Ms. Payne's life has been, quote, turned upside down since she pursued, attacked, and ended this man's life, and that she was trying to do what she could to, quote, be a good citizen and help out law enforcement, although law enforcement told her to mind her business. He also added that she's never had so much as a speeding ticket, and he is described as painting his client as some holier-than-thou defendant, a woman who is not a criminal and someone who is even above the act she committed. In his address to the court, he does what they all do, invoke the good old statement that she's an all-American girl, a good Samaritan, who thought she was helping out when she pursued, attacked, and ended Kenneth Herring. Even though, I say again, the 911 operator told her not to do so. Does this remind you of anything? Does the name Trayvon Martin ring a bell? It does to me. Her hearing has been delayed several times since this incident that took place on May 7th of 2019. So much so that she is now 22 years old. The latest is that they added new charges to her existing indictment at the hearing that took place in June of 2020, those being ending someone's life with malice, false imprisonment, and aggressive assault. This woman was initially charged with ending this man's life without malice and was released on a $100,000 bond. Think about that for a minute. You pursue, attack, and end someone's life after being told by 911 not to pursue, attack, and end someone's life, and yet you get to go home. Anyway, she was rearrested after witnesses recounted to the grand jury that she was acting aggressively and she assaulted this 62-year-old grandfather who was in the middle of a diabetic episode by punching him, screaming, "Get out of the effing car," at him while he appeared to be in medical distress, according to the witnesses on the scene, who didn't help him, by the way. But that's for another day. Her lawyer, Matt Tucker, continues to try and paint this demon as some good Samaritan and says she is truly upset by the ordeal and that she also doesn't think that she belongs in jail because she is what she calls a good person. And the judge agreed because, as it stands, she's at home. This woman's family and friends claim that they don't agree with how she is being portrayed to the public because she is a beloved family member and that she's not racist. And of course, the obligatory statement that all racists use, quite frankly, she has a black friend. So of course, she could never be racist. And the other uncode statement that Karens and those that bring Karens in the world say, her mother in this case, that she is the most sweetest and caring person and one who doesn't see color or race. She's right. She doesn't see color. All she sees is rage and privilege. And she used that to take this man's life because in this country, when you're what they call all American, you can't. This 62-year-old man's wife, Miss Christine, describes her husband as a grandfather of three, a hardworking man, a good father, a husband, and just an all-around good person. She says she's still trying to figure out why she was actually following Mr. Heron that day, why this Karen blocked him and then ultimately ended his life. I will link the change.org petition started by Anjanette Heron Stosier requesting that the governor, Brian Kemp, and the district attorney of Clayton County, Tasha Mosley, fulfill their duties of prosecuting this killer in the description box, where there is a call to get justice for this man because this demon is still on the loose at her home, awaiting trial, complaining about her ankle monitor being too tight or whatever, and the 9 p.m. curfew she has to adhere to. As you all know, normally I don't infuse my feelings into the cases I report on, but this one required some personal commentary on my part because Kenneth Heron was minding his business. And she says he was fleeing the scene of an accident, which was later shown not to be true as he was trying to save his own life by going to the hospital. But this killer felt it was her place to pursue, attack, and end this man's life because she thought he was drunk when he wasn't. Fam, this could have been mine or your grandfather, dad, brother, cousin, or uncle. And I'm pretty sure if this were a white 62-year-old husband, father, grandfather, a hardworking man, there would be no reporting of this incident because, as we all know, she would have done what they all do when they supposedly witness one of their own doing what they deem to be illegal acts. They mind their business. I will update you on this case and let you know if and when this deviant goes to trial. So stay tuned for more. And if you haven't already, remember to like this video as it helps the content reach a larger audience, which is always a plus. Also, share and turn on your notification bell, and I will catch you in the next one. Stay safe, because there are more Karens like this one roaming around.
She's my girlfriend.
Goodbye.
It's not true. Because you can really tell, like, all the Hannah's friends, you can really see. Even me, though. She's not like that.
What's your nationality?
Dominican.
You're Dominican?
Yes, sir.
So you don't see her seeing race?
At all.
So what do you think when you hear people make this into a race issue?
Well, people that they said that because they race. That's what I think. Because if you see right here, I'm not seeing color, though. We just humans. That's what I think.
I've been best friends with her since I was 14, and I'm 20 now, so.